Welcome behind the scenes of our latest fashion shoot using Lensbabies. Hey guys, welcome to Phlearn. My name is Aaron Nace. You can find me on Twitter at AKNacer. Today, we're taking a look behind the scenes of our recent fashion photo shoot, and we did it all using these Lensbabies. Lensbaby sent us this Pro Effects kit for review on Phlearn, and it's really cool. It comes with a Composer Pro, which is basically the base system, and you can put a couple different lenses in there. They have a Sweet 35 optic, which kind of creates a radial blur around the edges, and an Edge 80, which kind of creates a slice. And we were playing around with it in the studio and we thought, well, why don't we just go ahead and push a little bit further and do something that most people probably wouldn't do with a Lensbaby, to do a high fashion shoot using a lens like this. And I gotta tell you, the results are stunning and we had a lot of fun doing it. So the concept for this was actually really simple. We just wanted to create some great fashion shoots. And to do that, we looked at some photographers around the internet, as well as you can see we have an inspiration wall behind us. We looked at like Michael David Adams, Merton Marcus, Rankin, and some other ones, and basically kind of got an idea of how we wanted to do these shots. So everything was going to be lit with multiple light sources, mostly hard light sources as well, and we're using a lot of color to really bring out interest in these photos. So we've got a lot of color, a lot of flare, and that worked perfectly when using the Lensbabies. So we decided to up the ante a little bit in this shoot, and for the first time ever, we shot almost exclusively with bare bulb. What that means is you've got your light here and you're shooting basically with just this bulb. That means you're not using soft boxes or reflectors or anything to actually modify how this light comes out. We did use quite a bit of gels, which we basically just taped right over the cone here, and using bare bulb gave us some really interesting results and something I had never played with before. So it kind of introduced some really cool challenges, but it also gave us different results than we would normally get. Now, a lot of the time people don't really cover posing models, and being that this was a fashion shoot, that was an incredibly important part of the shoot. And there are a couple different techniques that are going to help you guys out when posing your models. The first technique is just look at references. You can see we have a reference wall behind us and we look at it all the time. Grab a couple pictures off of the internet and you can actually print them out or put them on your phone so you can do a couple sample poses. You can say, okay, go through this one, go through that one, go through that one, and then your models can actually see what's going on in these photos and they can pose with those as well. So it's gonna help you a lot when working with the models because they can just kind of see something and then imitate it. The second tip is that if something like feels really uncomfortable for the model, if they're kind of posing in a weird kind of direction like this or something, it's probably gonna look uncomfortable on camera. So you really want them to get stretch out and use the angles of their body to really get something interesting. But if they're feeling like really uncomfortable and it looks forced, it's probably going to come across as forced in the end photo as well. So you can tell them to kind of, I do the shakeout technique. If a model's like, you know, this, and I can just see they're really tense, I was like, all right, shake it out. Let's just start over again and do something a little bit more natural. And they'll usually like just go into a pose that works a little bit better. And the last tip is get in the place of the model and pose yourself. If you want to look like an idiot on shoot, I really don't mind it. I think it's a lot of fun. It kind of opens things up a little bit. So you'll find me actually like doing the pose of the model, kind of getting, it helps to get a feel of what the space is actually like and how you can move around your body. And then you can get a feel of, okay, this is kind of the idea that I want. Step back behind the camera, the model can kind of imitate the pose you made. And it usually works out pretty well. So the equipment used for the shoot was actually really simple. We weren't using a whole lot of lighting modifiers, and that meant we could keep everything like down to a bare minimum. We were using these guys bare bulb, oftentimes with gels on them. So if you place a gel on the top of your strobe, and you know, you can see this doesn't fit, but you can just kind of tape something down like that and get it to work for you. These are relatively durable and not too expensive as well. So using the lighting modifiers as well as the gels. Now, the only thing we did need to do let's say we're putting a gel or a gelled light right next to someone and that light is spilling back onto the wall behind them. Sometimes you really don't want that. You want a separation between your subject and their background. So you can use things like these flags, just stick them on a light stand or something like that, and that will kind of block the light coming from a certain direction. So we use these flags in a lot of cases just to kind of, you know, go beside the light and make sure they don't hit areas we want. And then of course we were just using a camera with a simple lens on it, and yeah, everything was super easy and quick, and which was really great for this shoot because it allowed us a lot of creativity. So we wanted to create as many looks as possible over this one day shoot. Our goal was 20. I think we wound up with something like 15. Now, don't always expect for every single one of those shots to turn out. I think, you know, two or three of the shots from the day just didn't turn out as I wanted. So still not a big deal because we still have a lot of other shots to fall back on, but if you kind of planned, you know, go for a couple more shots than you actually need out of a shoot, usually you can throw away the worst two and you're still left with a better crop of the whole. Now, because this was a fashion shoot, a lot of what makes these images great really had nothing to do with me. We had a great wardrobe stylist, Reggie, we had an awesome makeup artist, Christina, and our hairstylist, Jamie, kicked butt. So these people really created the look of the photos, and I'm just the guy who takes the pictures. So keep in mind, guys, all these shots you see, they're a production by many, many different people, each of which is a professional at their own thing. So you don't have to be the person who picks out all the clothes. You don't have to be the person who's great at makeup. Just find those people who are good, get them on your team, and you can create some amazing results together. Now, one of the reasons why we chose two models is because, you know, oftentimes doing like hair and makeup and styling, they're really important, but they can take a little bit of time. So if one model, you're photographing one model, the other model can be getting ready for the next shoot, and you can just kind of like swap them out back and forth over and over again. So there's really no downtime when you're doing something like this, and you can wind up getting a lot more looks out of the same amount of time. Guys, thanks so much for taking a look behind the scenes of our recent fashion shoot using bare bulb lighting and lens babies. Using things like these kind of force us to get out of our comfort zone and into a little bit more of a creative bubble. So I would recommend totally switching up your normal processes, because you might wind up finding an entirely new process that works for you in a great way.